Alright, here we go. This is Sonic 3D Blast on the Genesis Mega Drive, also known as Sonic 3D Flickies Island, depending on where you are. That's what it's called in Europe, or PAL territories, I should say. Now, the first thing I want to say is, this is actually pretty impressive what they did with this beginning video intro here, considering, the hardware's on and this is not on the Sega CD or the 32X. But at the same time, you need to remember, this came out in 1996. The almost end of the Genesis Mega Drive's life, that is when it was getting actual games still, not just sports games, so by then they pretty much could figure out how to do that kind of stuff. So the story goes is that Sonic's, this island, has got the birds called the Flickies. Dr. Robotnik comes across some figures out this yet another way to get the Chaos Emeralds, because that's all he thinks about. And Sonic goes there and he finds a bunch of robots, which he knows is supposed to be the birds, his buddies. And then he finds out, just the same as all the other shit he's done in the past, if he basically bounces on them, he'll pop them back open and they'll turn back into the birds again. And that's all there is to it, and that's what you do. Now, there's a couple things I'm going to explain with this. First of all, I'm doing this not as I'm playing, of course, because anymore lately it's not been going good for me. I've had this restart so many damn times, and it's getting frustrating for me. It's just not going good, so I think I might go back to doing it like this like I used to. But anyway, that's all I wanted to say about that real quick out of the way. Now, here's another thing I want to explain about this game is, you might not know it or not, but this is sometimes... I don't think anymore it is usually, because I think people mostly forgot about this, even though I haven't, because I'm Sega and a Sonic fan, is that sometimes this is usually considered among, not the most, but one of the worst Sonic games ever made. Now, I wouldn't go that far. It's definitely not what I would call a great one or even that good of a one. I'd call it an average or mediocre one. But, no, I wouldn't, me personally, I would not definitely consider this the worst. It is playable. Such as it is. The number one worst problem with this, I'll get it out of the way right now and tell you flat out, the worst problem with this game is the controls. Just as you're watching this, look in the video and pay attention how many times I have to make Sonic spin around like a friggin' idiot top just to get these stupid birds to follow him, or get rings or whatever. The controls are horrible. It's borderline what's acceptable, basically. It's frustrating to play, and it also, the controls are in tandem problem with the angle at what you're viewing at, because a lot of times, you can't tell if you're actually going to land on something or not. Case in point, what you're seeing right here, I'm trying to jump on this fucking thing and not hit the spike ball. It's not that easy. Even someone like me, who has played this quite a few times and has gotten used to it, doesn't change the fact that the controls are not as good as they're supposed to be, or they should be. It's just not. This is nowhere near as good as Sonic 1, 2, and 3 and Sonic & Knuckles. Those still remain the best 2D Sonic games. Well, this one's mostly 2D. It's got part 3D, part 2D, which is another thing. A lot of people didn't go for that back then. It was different. Difference not always bad, but with something like this, it's not really what people were expecting or hoping for, so that didn't really work well either. It got mixed reviews when it came out as a result, and the control problems and some of other things. One of the other things is that as you watch this, you might figure it out, even though I only show you the first two acts, is that the levels are very repetitive. There's not much that changes between them. The landscape, which almost looks, by the way, like one of the early Sim Cities, how if you use that one tool, you can make the ground raise or lower. Remember, they were kind of limited what they could do with it, but it almost reminds me of that if I had to compare it to something. The level design doesn't really change all that much. In fact, look at the enemies. They don't go for you. They don't try attacking you. Even those purple, like, giant wasp things, they only move around in their own little circle. They don't really try coming after you and attacking you. There's only one enemy that really directly even tries to attack, and even then, it alternates where it's facing, that turret. You can't kill it, but it can hurt you. That's all there is to it. It doesn't really go after you much, and as you see here, this spike ball just goes back and forth on the plane. It doesn't really try attacking you, so there's... Really, there's no enemies that even try to kill you directly, so there's no challenge in that either. I mean, I'm not gonna say it's just a flat-out easy game. I mean, later on it does get a little bit challenging, but overall, the game, the best way to summarize it is not exactly the Sonic game it should have been, and it's frustrating, but it's not the worst Sonic game. I never really agreed with that Sonic 3D Blast or Sonic 3D Flickies Island, whatever one you want to call it, is the worst Sonic game. It's got frustrating as hell controls that should have been better, but other than that, I don't know. One of the other things is, I definitely think one of the problems is the view angle. Now, I've played a lot of games that are isometric. One of the most famous ones, if I had to give an example of ones I know, is probably Diablo, which is an action RPG. You're using a mouse and keyboard in that. You have a mouse and you direct where your character is going, where you attack and stuff like that. What I'm getting at is it's not a platformer that doesn't require precision. You use precision with a mouse. It's a little bit different when you're just clicking on stuff. With this, you're trying to make precise jumps. It doesn't really work that well when you have an awkward camera angle. That's my point here, and I've heard that complaint brought up many other times before. There's that wasp I was talking about, the purple wasp. But like I said, I definitely do not think this is one of the worst Sonic games. Does it belong somewhere on a list of bad Sonic games? Most part, yeah, but like I said, if I had to really judge it on anything and be fair as much as I can with it, it's average. This is an average Sonic game. There's really not that much to it, really. All you're doing is collecting, that is right. You kill certain of these enemies, the ones you can kill, because obviously these ones you can't kill for anything. There's no way to do it. And even then, there's none of the flickies in them. That's not what you're supposed to be doing. You kill the enemies that have the flickies, and you turn them back into the birds. You collect the birds in tow behind you, and you take them to the rings, and you deposit them, depending on how many you have, in the lower corner there on the right. And then you go to the next level of that stage. Or, in this case, this is the last area of the stage, so now I get warped up into a UFO, and that's it. Yeah, I thought that was the funniest thing ever when I first played this, is Sonic's getting abducted by an alien. It's hilarious. But that's not what's going on. Other than that, there's not much else to say about it. You still have the same stuff that you did in the previous games on the Genesis Mega Drive and even the Sega CD. You still collect rings, you get enough of them, which I do once in this. I get 100 and I get a life, so that still works the same. You find these Sonic Head tokens, which you can only rarely reach when you have the birds, because they extend to your... It's almost like a whip or a chain. It extends how high you can reach, so you use them to get that. And you still have all the same items. You still can find the fast run shoes. You can still find the bubble shield, which I've already gotten at least once or twice in this. This thing, which makes you invincible, works exactly the same as it does in the previous games. So, really not much else to that change. The only real thing that's different here is what you're doing to get through the levels. You have to collect the birds. You have to get them all. Otherwise, you can't complete the level. And the enemies aren't even nearly as challenging as they are in the previous games. The game doesn't play as fast, even though you can move fast. It's just you can't control it as well as in the past games, and it's just not as fun. It's an average game. That's the most fair assessment you can give about it. It's an average game. It's not horrendous bad, it's not what we'd actually consider a bad game. It's not a great game or a good game. It's just average. It's in between. It's middle of the road, and there's nothing wrong with that. There's nothing wrong with an average game, and I've said that for many years, especially about this game. I've said if you actually give it a time, and you actually try it, like I have, and I've played it for at least 4 times full, I don't want to anymore, but if you actually give it a chance, it's an average game. Do I recommend it? That's hard. If you're into the Genesis Mega Drive a lot, like say I am, or Sonic, or you just like the Sonic games a lot, or you're collecting for a Genesis Mega Drive, then yeah, I would. Funny thing is, this is actually one of the harder ones I've had trying to find it. Oh, and by the way, that was Knuckles right there. If you go to see him, he does stuff, but nothing really necessary. You don't have to. But yeah, he's in this. I don't know. I don't know what else to say about that. You do come across a few characters. Amy's in this, and that's about there's. Well, at least I think. I don't remember. Is she in this? I think she is. I don't know. I'm trying to talk on the fly here. But anyway, Knuckles is in this, and so on and so forth. But overall, it's an average game. That's all there is to say about it. The most frustrating thing and the worst thing about it is the controls, how they control, because it's just you move around like you're on freaking ice. I mean, you've already seen me in this video how many times, even if I'm not talking while playing it, you could tell when I was getting frustrated trying to get the thing to run. Not only that, missing the jumps and hitting those spiky balls when I was trying to hit the enemy. And then there's this right here. This is what I was talking about a few minutes ago when I said, watch for the part when I'm trying to spin around trying to get this flicky. Look at this. This is not the hallmarks of a good controlling game if you have to do that kind of shit. If I had to say what's worse, the jumping when you're trying to directly hit something or do it, catching these birds. The birds are probably the worst, because they run around like chickens without their head. They're really stupid. They just move around all kinds of weird-ass patterns. The red ones, for whatever reason, are the hardest to get. I've never understood that. Maybe it's because they're smaller, but they're not any smaller than some of these other ones. Not by much. I don't know. Hitbox is smaller, I guess. But it's one of those things, This is definitely not one of the better games you can get for the Genesis Mega Drive, as far as Sonic games go, of course. Or even platformers, for that regard. but it's average. It's still worth playing at least once or maybe even twice. You know, once the first time is, you know, you're getting used to it. The second time is when you already know what you're doing and see how good you can get through it. Beyond that, though, it's not like Sonic 2, for example. It's not like Sonic and Knuckles. It's not one you're going to be coming back to a lot, you know. The best thing about it is the music. Flat out, I'll tell you that right now. Now, as far as the visuals go, this is pretty impressive. The Saturn version has a visual upgrades up from what this is, but even taking this for what it is, it still looks pretty good. It's also on the computer. I'll have it all in the game info, but, you know, in the end, I think this could have been better. As you might have noticed in the beginning, it said Traveler's Tales. They're the ones that actually developed this, not Sega themselves, so that might have been one of the reasons why this is a little wonky. But Traveler's Tales, they're a good developer. I've played many of the things they've done. They're not around anymore, if I remember right. Like now, you know, in 2014, they're not around anymore doing stuff. Or maybe they are, I just don't know. They haven't made anything in a while, but, or they've been bought out. I don't know. But it's still worth playing for what it is, even though it's an average game. That's about what there's to it, you know. The music's really good, though. It's nice you have a sound test menu you can mess with, you know, right in the beginning. You might have saw it before I started. And it's got a different Sega intro. It's a 3D animated Sega intro, and the guy actually screams Sega instead of the musical sing-song, Sega, which I like better. But, you know, as far as Sonic games go, I can list so many more that are far worse than this, and I'm pretty sure you know one of them that I'd probably say that everyone knows is the worst one, without a doubt, most likely, is Sonic 2006, or actually it's called Sonic the Hedgehog, but most people call it Sonic 06, but whatever. So that's it, that's Sonic 3D Blast, also known as Sonic 3D Flickies Island. I don't know, this one was more me explaining about the game, but I don't know what else to say. So that's it, thanks for watching, and I will see you next time.